Many unknowns about COVID-19, but what we do know is that people are affected in very different ways by the virus. Max Rodriguez, spoke to scientists who are working to find out who's more prone to be on the severe end of the disease and why.
A Honolulu company and a UH professor are teaming up to see if certain populations can become more sick than others when it comes to COVID-19. No matter your age, ethnicity, or socioeconomic status, we're all prone to contracting the coronavirus. But scientists suspect some people may experience symptoms more severe than others.
As you know, a lot of people are asymptomatic when they get COVID-19, while others end up in the hospital. Of course, age and predispositions to other conditions have an impact, but we're looking at how the DNA actually can contribute.
Cyril Mukarzel, CEO of Life DNA, says our DNA makeup is largely the same for all of us, but there are some differences. Some people may have more of a specific receptor or proteins in their lungs that COVID-19 latches onto.
We're looking specifically at the ACE2 receptor, so how many of those you have. That's what the virus attaches to. So you genetically might have less than others, and that would be beneficial in this case. If you have more, then it's easier for the virus to come in.
Genetics and different ethnic backgrounds could play a role in the way the virus multiplies in our bodies. Researchers want to find out just how big that role is.
If you look at the infection rates and the mortality, basically, around the globe now with this pandemic, you can really see that there seems to be big differences between different nations.
UH Associate Professor Mari Tirikainen says Hawaii is a perfect place for the research due to its diversity.
We would need to get DNA samples from people who have been tested and both tested negative and positive for the virus so that we can really start comparing if there are genetic differences.
Right now, the researchers are contacting labs and physicians to get DNA samples. Crowdsourcing may also be an option. They hope their findings can help identify groups who may be more at risk in a future outbreak. Max Rodriguez, K22 News, working for Hawaii.